This is World Championship Cricket. We're at the group stage of the tournament. Richie Benno is going to be here with me, Mark Nicholas. And if what we've seen so far is anything to go by, we have much to look forward to. This is a hard surface, and it looks to me as if it'll even bounce and good carry through to the wicketkeeper. I'd be batting first if I won this toss. This excellent batting surface. It's fair enough to bat first, get runs on the board, and put the opposition under pressure.
So we're all ready for the first ball of the innings. No shot played to that one. Wide ball, signal by the umpire. Big shout for that one. That has to be close. The umpire says, not out.
Ooh, just missing off stump. Close.
Let's take a look at that in slow motion. Safely taken by Miles.
They were looking for that early wicket and not disappointed.
Collingwood gets his first wicket. He's gone for a duck.
Scores haven't had to do much with that innings.
This was how the wicket fell. Never looked like being a run there.
Oh no, that's a terrible call. There was never a run in that. Never.
He's gone for a duck.
It is a long old walk back when you've made a duck. Quack, quack.
It's straight to a field. That looked really nasty. I'll be surprised if we see him again in this innings. He's edged it and could get some runs if they're quick. That is a glorious. Oh, what a catch by Peterson.
Very safely done. He's got soft hands, his eyes were level, crucially held onto as well.
Collingwood gets his second wicket.
Top stuff today, constantly asking questions of the batsman, and the wickets column prove just that. Well, he wasn't there for long, and the score proves it.
That must be close.
Now. The ball hit the pads outside the line of off stump. I don't see how that given out.
Let's see a replay of that. What foolish running. That's simply throwing wickets away.
There was never a never. You sensed it from the off. I can't even believe they tried it.
He's gone for a duck.
He hasn't troubled the scorers with that knock.
Pitch it to a fielder. Flintoff continues. Stopped in the covers. Edged. Safe. The batsman might get runs here. That's a brilliant shot. Right off the meat of the bat. Flintoff is not impressed.
Excellent shot. Excellent. Such an exciting player to watch.
And the end of the over. I'm not sure if he'll be able to continue. He looks to be in some pain.
Clean bowled.
Great bowling. Perhaps extra piece did it, and it went straight through him. I mean, that's a fantastic ball.
That's the third wicket now for Collingwood.
It's been a world-class piece of bowling out there today.
He's gone for a duck.
Well, he wasn't out in the middle for long. He didn't trouble the scorers, and neither did he trouble us.
Take a look at that in slow motion. Straight through to the... That's been given wide. Straight to a fielder. Flintoff is going to try. Right over the wicket.
That must have hurt. He looks to be in a little bit of trouble out there. Flintoff continues. It's straight to a fielder. Yeah, you got problems. Flintoff is coming around there. That's a superb shot. We can have a look at that again. The sweep picks up.
It's pretty tough for the bowlers on a pitch like this. There doesn't seem to be any margin for error.
No shot played to that one.
That's been given as a wide.
Collingwood continues.
That was a no ball by Collingwood. There's the umpire signal, no ball. And the end of the over.
Behind the run rate, they got to go.
He's going to try over. There's the umpire signal, no ball. Comfortably taken, no worries.
Oh, the batsman will be kicking himself. It was such a good shot, he looked in good touch, and it's an unbelievable bit of fielding.
Collingwood gets his fourth wicket.
Top class bowling today, perfect lengths, perfect lines, and no batsman really finding the answer. Oh, that's a beauty. What a hook stroke. It's a brutal shot to play that, but he kept it down and comfortably beat the fielder. Beauty. What a hook stroke. It's a difficult shot to play out, but he kept it down and comfortably beat the fielder.
Well, that'll certainly beat the fielder into the fence.
Fantastic shot there. And I think he knew it was four just as soon as he struck it.
Off is switching to round the wicket. That's the end of the 10th over. Oh, comprehensive bowl.
Well, he just got everything wrong and played all around a pretty straight ball.
Five for Paul Collingwood. Well, there's something to celebrate. I'm not going to say that it won't ever happen again, but I think he should revel in it. He's bowled well. Just a touch of swing and a consistent line and length for the man from Durham.
This was how the wicket... Collingwood continues. It's straight to a fielder. Collingwood continues. Big shout for that one. The umpire says, not out. That was a difficult decision for the umpire.
Well, I think that's done a bit too much. Great delivery, though.
It's straight to a fielder. Out caught.
Well taken. Well taken. You know, he never looked like seeing it.
Collingwood gets his sixth wicket.
It's been a world-class piece of bowling out there today.
He's gone for a duck.
Well, hasn't troubled the scorers with that, not.
Collingwood continues. Done him and shattered the stumps.
Well, very well balled, straight and full when it mattered.
Collingwood gets his seventh wicket.
Top class stuff today, constantly asking questions of the batsman, and the wickets column prove just that.
He's gone for a duck.
That has to be close. We can have a look at that again. He played all around
. Welcome back to the second session of what has been a most interesting contest so far. The players are out in the middle, and in the commentary box is Richie Ben.
Thanks, Mark.
And it's Andrew Flint facing. Straight drive is his favourite stroke. We know that, they should know that, and it goes.
Beautiful piece of batting, that.
Excellent bowling. It's straight and it's full, and in the end, you miss, buddy, and I'll hit. And taking guard now is Michael Vaughan.
Just one run. Pitch straight to a fielder. Just one run. There should be some run here. A hopeful shout, and the batsman was easily in. Collingwood waiting at the striker's end. And the end of the over.
Generally, batsmen like to keep the scoreboard ticking. If they get bogged down, they begin to get frustrated, and that, of course, is when the chances come.
I'm not sure if he'll be able to continue. He looks to be in some pain.
Pitch straight to a fielder. There'll be runs here. The fielder's appeal, but he was quite comfortably home. That's two more runs on the board. Pitch straight to a fielder.
He's got it into the gap.
There's just one there.
Collingwood
waiting at the striker's end.
Ooh, that looked quite nasty.
Confident appeal. No response from the umpire.
The angle of the delivery surely takes that down the leg side.
Let's see the action replay.
Collingwood
waiting at the striker's end.
Collingwood
facing.
That's a good one. Well timed and four. Beautifully placed. Good easing, good nick.
Well, that's found the gap in the field. Just one run.
really tough for the bowlers on a pitch like this. There doesn't seem to be any margin for error.
Let's see the action replay. Collingwood waiting at the striker's end. It's straight to a fielder. Collingwood waiting at the striker's end. He looked as if he was home to me. That's the end of the fifth over. Vaughan is now facing. That's a big appeal. The umpire says, not out. Let's take a look at that slope. Well, that was a very confident shot.
Well, the trouble with bowling there is that it's a favourite area and he'll hammer you every time.
Vaughan waiting at the striker's end. Steered expertly in the gap. There's one there. Struck in front. He's out.
He's not happy with that. I don't know what the complaint is, but ooh, he does not look happy.
Bell is the next man in. That really is a suicidal run out.
There was never a run there, never. You sensed it from the off. I can't even believe they tried it.
This was how the innings ended for Vaughan.
This is Kevin Peterson.
The sweeper picks up. Just one run. Bell facing. That struck him in front. Lowell. Yes, he's given him. That's a duck for Bell.
No, doesn't look happy with that.
We can have a look at that again.
And facing now, Andrew Strauss.
That must be close.
Yes, he's given him.
Strauss is out for a duck.
I think he'll have a close look at the replay when he gets back into the pavilion. Well bowled. Very well bowled. If you keep it that tight, the batsmen begin to feel a bit strangled. A great stroke. My goodness, this guy can play. What a pleasure to watch him, too.
Out. Bowl.
What a cracking delivery. Well, he wasn't there for long, and the score proves it.
Giles is the next batsman. Just shoulders arms to that one. Wide ball signalled by the umpire. Giles facing. Big shout for that one. We can have a look at that again.
Well, he just got everything wrong and played all out a pretty straight ball.
First ball.
First baller, that is just so embarrassing. And rest assured, there'll be a few comments from the crowd as he heads back towards the pavilion. And it's Marcus Trescothick on strike.
Foolish running, that's simply throwing wickets away.
Oh, that's just a waste. Terrible waste of a wicket. Desperately bad communication by the batsman out there.
He's gone for a duck.
Scores haven't had to do much with that innings.
Waiting at the striker's end. Confident appeal.
He's out. He's gone for a duck.
I don't think he agrees with that decision by the umpire.
Let's take a look at that in slow motion. The next batsman is
Harmison.
Lay it away with comfort.
And they've wrapped up limited overs fixture with a great win. They came into the game well prepared and ready to produce the goods, and that's exactly what they did. On behalf of Richie Beno and myself, Mark Nicholas, we bid you a good afternoon and look forward to bringing you cricket coverage in the very near future. Bye-bye for now.